Hey everyone, this is Aagam Singh Sisodiya and you're watching Disease Media. Today, you are going to know about angiography and angioplasty. Angiography is the diagnostic technique used by the doctor to diagnose the contraction and the blockage in the veins and arteries, while the angioplasty is the technique which is used to clear out the blockage from veins and arteries. So before going to know about the angiography and angioplasty in brief, firstly we have to know some important question related to angiography and angioplasty so that it becomes easy for us to relate us that what is angiography and angioplasty in a very easy manner. Let's start with the first question, that is why blockage occurs. Blockage occurs due to the plaque formation in the veins and arteries that obstruct the flowing of blood in a normal way. It's just like a drainage when water is flowing from a drainage, and when sometimes lots of garbage is accumulated at area in a drainage, then it will obstruct the flowing of water from one side to another side. As such, in the case of blood vessels, when the plaque deposition occurs, then it obstructs the flowing of blood from one point to another. Now from this point, another question arises that what is the cause of this plaque formation? The cause of plaque formation is the high level of cholesterol and triglycerides in the blood of that person. Means that when lots of triglycerides and cholesterol are present in the person's blood, then they start to accumulate in the veins and arteries also. That creates the obstruction or the blockage problem. Now a final question arises that what are the problems faced by the person with the blockage of artery or a vein? The answer is very simple. You can understand it in a very easy way, that our heart pumps the blood and the veins and arteries are the carriers of the blood to the whole body. And when the veins and arteries become blocked, then the blood supply becomes abnormal. Means that the proper blood which is circulated in the whole body becomes obstructed due to the accumulation of plaque in that particular area. So due to the less supply of the blood, the organs cannot work in a proper way, in a normal way. Okay, and the chest pain is also there because the blood is obstructed there because of the accumulation of plaque. So the problem occurs in a very big way in the whole body. So by seeing the situation and the symptoms of that person, doctor will advise the patient to have an angiography. Now let's start with the angiography. As I told that it is a diagnostic procedure based on X-ray which is used to diagnose the blockage and the contraction area in the veins and arteries. The first step of angiography is the injection of a very fine tube known as catheter from the blood vessels to our heart. Means that doctor firstly have to clean that area. For example, the two most common areas which are used for the injection of catheter is the wrist and the groin area. Firstly, they have to clean that area, and after that they will make a cut, a very small cut in that area, and after that they will inject the catheter with a special instrument and guide the catheter with the help of X-ray to reaches to our heart. When the catheter reaches to our heart, then the second step start, that is injection of contrast dye in the catheter. Means that catheter, as you know, is a very fine tube. So when the doctor will inject the contrast dye, which is a special type of tracking dye. Okay, what is the use? We will going to know about that. Firstly, they will inject the contrast dye from the catheter, and the catheter will take this dye to the coronary arteries. Now the third step start, in which with the help of contrast dye and the X-ray imaging, the doctor will see inside the coronary artery. Means that with the help of contrast dye and with the help of X-ray imaging, the doctor can see the images inside the coronary artery, that where is the blockage, where is the problem, and make a report which is known as angiogram, from which they can diagnose the blockage or the contraction area. Now a very important point that you have to note, that angiography is the technique which is used to diagnose the blockage or the contraction area. While angiogram is the report created through angiography, which clearly defines the blockage or contraction area which is present in a particular segment of coronary artery or vein. So after diagnosing the contraction or the blockage area in the coronary artery or vein, the doctor will suggest the patient to have an angioplasty. Now, what is angioplasty? As I told earlier, that angioplasty is the clearing or the treatment of the plaque area or the blockage. So now let's understand the procedure of angioplasty. The procedure of angioplasty starts by injecting a very thin wire from the catheter to the blockage area. when the wire reaches to the blockage area, then a very small balloon is introduced with the help of wire to that blockage area. Means that a very tiny balloon is sent with the help of that guided wire to that blockage area. And when the balloon reaches to that blocked area, then the doctors will inflate that balloon so that the artery will become broadened up and the plaque which is deposited in the walls of the artery will become shrinked up and the way of blood should to be flow in a normal way. For this, the doctor will do the process of inflation and deflation in an n numbers of time so that the artery will become broader and the plaque will goes in a very very side and becomes shrinked up. Okay, after that the procedure is completed, when the way is clear, now the doctors will shrink out the balloon and take it out from the body. And after that, they will again send a balloon to that blocked area, but this time the balloon is not alone. The balloon contains a stent over it. So when the balloon with a stent reaches to that block area, the doctor will inflate that balloon. And now with the inflation of the balloon, the stent also becomes broader and collapses with the walls of the artery and fix there up. When the procedure is done, the doctor will take out the balloon, the wire, the catheter out from the body. So now by having that stent, the blood can flow easily from that part of the vein or artery. Now again, a very important thing that you have to note that in many cases after angioplasty also, the plaque formation occurs in a regular basis and the person getting lots of problems, lots of symptoms due to it. So for preventing the plaque formation and treating yourself, you just have to follow three very, very important precautions. The first thing that you have to take a healthy heart diet, which is less in fats and sugar. Because as you know, plaque formation is due to the fat deposition in the veins and arteries. Second thing that you have to make your body activated by doing workouts and physical exercises so that the blood supply becomes proper in your body. Third thing that is very, very important that you have to lose your weight according to your height and age because the fat is not only accumulated in your side or in your stomach, it is also accumulated in your veins and arteries that creates the blockage-like problems and even cause heart attack. So that's all about angiography and angioplasty. I hope this video is helpful for you and enhance your knowledge. If you like this video, then give it a thumbs up, share this video with your family and friends, and subscribe this channel to get more interesting videos such like that. You can also follow me on my social media. I have my Twitter, I have my Facebook, I have my Instagram, and I have my Hindi YouTube channel, Biology with Aagam Singh. So that's all for today. I will see you later in the next video.